Okay, so today we have a problem from classical mechanics. So let me read the problem for you. The Hamiltonian for a particle of mass m is h equals to p square by 2m plus k into q into t, where q and p are the generalized coordinate and momentum respectively. T is the time and k is a constant. For the initial condition q equals to 0 and p equals to 0 at t equals to 0, q of t has been found to be t to the power alpha. What will be the value of alpha? So this is a very good question. How can you solve this particular problem? So your Hamiltonian value is given, h equals to p square by 2m plus k into q into t. Okay, Hamiltonian is given, p square upon 2m plus k into q into t. This is given in the question. Q and p are the generalized coordinate and momentum, as you know. And for initial condition, q equals to 0, p equals to 0, t equals to 0. You also given q equals to 0, p is equals to 0 at t is equals to 0, and it has been found q of t is proportional to t to the power alpha. Q of t is proportional to t to the power alpha. We have to find out the value of alpha. This one we have to do. So if Hamiltonian is given, we can write the Hamiltonian's equation of motion. Hamiltonian's or Hamilton's equation of motion. We can write Hamilton's equation of motion. What are the Hamiltonian's equation of motion? We can write of q dot and p dot. Q dot is equals to del h by del p, and p dot is equals to minus del h by del q. H is given, so q dot is equals to del h by del p, so p by m. And what will be p dot? P dot equals to minus del h by del q equals to minus k times p. So dp dt, from here we can find out dp dt equals to minus kt. As you can, so q of t is depending on p, so that is why we need to evaluate p first. So from here we get p is equals to minus kt square upon 2 plus c1. So one constant integration constant, we are getting c1, and we can easily remove it using the initial conditions given to you. At t equals to 0, your p equals to 0, that gives you c1 equals to 0. If c1 equals to 0, your p becomes minus kt square upon 2. Now let's come back to this. Q dot equals to p by m, so dq dt is equals to p by m. We have got the value of p, minus kt square by 2, so it becomes minus kt square upon 2m. And from here we can find out the value of q of t equals to minus kt q by 6m plus some integration constant c2. Now at t equals to 0, qt is equals to 0. It is given in the question. So from here c2 is also 0. So ultimately we are getting q of t is equals to minus kt q by 6m. It is proportional to t to the power alpha. So alpha, as you can see, alpha's value is 3. So it is matching with option B. Option B is the correct option for this question. Thank you.
Unacademy is India's largest online teaching learning platform. You can prepare for various competitive exams like CSR NET, GET, JEST, IIT JAM, TFR. Especially if you are preparing for CSR NET Physical Science, you can join me on Unacademy Plus. I cover all the 9 units of CSR NET Physical Science syllabus. My approach is especially, I precisely give you the concept of the concerned topic. Then I discuss the relevant mathematical formula and do the analysis. Relevant problem based on the topic, including previous year questions, are discussed. Homework and assignments are also given. This is my profile, and if you want to join my Unacademy Plus courses, you can enroll for this course. And if you are new to this Unacademy platform, you can take Unacademy Plus subscription using our referral code FelixUp, and Unacademy will give you 10% off. So take the Unacademy Plus subscription today and put your feet one step ahead towards reaching your goal. Thank you.